Hello everyone, my name is Hagar, and for part one of the parameter and design recommendations videos, we will be discussing the key parameters of GANFETs and how they enable more efficiency and speed. In this video, we will be going over the parameter advantages GAN provides, its parasitic components, and their advantages. Let's start by discussing the advantages GAN provides in relation to its parameters. Firstly, GAN transistors' RDS(on) value is very low in comparison to silicon, which reduces conduction losses, leading to more efficient devices. Next, when it comes to GAN, its total gate charge is a lot lower, which results in faster switching and reduction in the gate drive losses. It's good to mention here that given GAN has no body diode, we also have zero reverse recovery charge, and thus no reverse recovery losses. When it comes to the maximum allowable gate to source voltage and the threshold voltage, GAN FETs have lower values. eGANFETs, for example, have a maximum gate to source voltage of about 6 volts. Usually, we recommend 5 volts be applied. Just like a MOSFET, GANFETs also have parasitic capacitances between each terminal. The input capacitance, CISS, is the sum of the gate to source and gate to drain capacitances. The output capacitance, COSS, is the sum of the drain to source and gate to drain capacitances. The feedback capacitance, or the reverse transfer capacitance, CRSS, is simply the gate-to-drain capacitance. Just as how it has parasitic capacitances, it also has parasitic inductances at each terminal. Now let's look at the key advantages coming from the parasitic capacitance of GANFETs. But before that, we will identify where these capacitances are located in a GANFET structure. The lateral structure of an enhancement GAN FET also makes it a very low capacitance device. In this lateral structure, the gate-to-source capacitance is the capacitance of the device from the 2DE channel to the field plate on top of the gate terminal. It consists of the junction from the gates in the channel and the capacitance of the dielectric between the gate and the field plate. The drain-to-source capacitance is the capacitance between the field plate and the drain terminal from the channel. Its value is limited to the capacitance across the dielectric layer from the field plate to the drain. Lastly, the gate-to-drain capacitance is located in a small portion from the gate terminal connected to the channel. When it comes to the size of these capacitances, the gate-to-drain capacitance is smaller in size relative to the gate-to-source and drain-to-source capacitances. And the drain-to-source capacitance is also relatively small. In addition, since the gate-to-source capacitance is larger than the gate-to-drain capacitance, this gives the GAN FET good dV/dt immunity, and its size is still smaller relative to SI MOSFETs. With these smaller capacitances, the values for input and output capacitances, CISS and COSS, are lower, which is the key to faster switching and more efficiency. More information can be found in these useful links.